Assalamualaikum dear students, our today's topic is electrophoresis, also called as gel electrophoresis, because medium which is used that is called as gel. So it's a technique which is used to separate fragments of a charge bearing polymer molecule. A polymer molecule is a molecule which is made up of many units. Poly means many and mer means unit. Like you know DNA that consists of number of nucleotides, similarly RNA that consists of RNA nucleotide, and proteins, they are made up of number of amino acids. So we call them what? Polymer molecules. So according to their size, shape, molecular weight and surface charge, whether they are having positive or negative charge, these polymer molecules, they can be separate on a gel with the help of electricity or in an electric field. That's why this technique is called as what? Electrophoresis. Now this is the apparatus which is used for electrophoresis or gel electrophoresis. It consists of a gel that is either made up of agarose or polyacrylamide. Agarose is a polysaccharide which is present in solid form in the lab, and we make a solution of it inside a buffer solution or a salt solution, and when it solidifies, it gives a gel like consistency which can be poured inside this apparatus, and then we make holes which are called as wells in during electrophoresis on one side of the gel with the help of a comb. The comb that comes along with this apparatus, and we pour our sample in these wells, and this is direction of movement of the sample, and on the two sides of the gel there is buffer solution or salt solution which helps the ions to move or molecules to move in this gel with the help of electricity. So this is power supply and this is negative electrode. As DNA that is negatively charged, so it will start moving towards the positive pole of the of this chamber or of this electrophoresis chamber or on the positive side of the machine. Okay, next is this technique utilizes a gel medium composed of agarose or polyacrylamide for separation of fragments, which is done under the influence of an electric field. Okay, next is the negative charged molecules will move towards the positive pole, and the molecules having positive charge will move towards the negative pole. The velocity of movement of fragment is inversely proportional to the size. What does it mean? Inversely proportional. If molecules they are smaller in size, then they will move faster, and if larger molecules they are there, then or larger fragments they are there, then they will move slow. Then working, the gel is sandwiched between glass or plastic plates to form a viscous slab. The two ends of the slabs are suspended into salt solutions, buffer solutions that are connected by electrodes to a power supply or power source. So when we apply a voltage to the apparatus, the molecules present in the gel migrate to the electric field according to their individual charge, and they move away from one another in the gel. So these molecules, they will start moving on that of the gel, and smaller molecules, they will move faster. It depends on the size of the pores which get created inside the gel, on the size of the fragment, or on the size of the charge which is present on that of the molecules, how do they move. So this is whole principle of electrophoresis. Thank you, students.